Good evening, good evening. I'm excited to see you all. How are you? So I am sitting in the actual Clarins virtual boutique, and can I tell you, it is a treasure trove of all things skincare and makeup. And I've been very restrained. I've not gone poking around in any stands or drawers, but I want to. I'm just going to wait for a moment, just chat away whilst more of you join, because I'm aware we are bang on time. Can you believe it's nearly Christmas? Look at all of these decorations behind me. Aren't they gorgeous? I want to steal them and take them home. In fact, I love they've put even some kind of gorgeous Christmas lollipops up there. What a fab idea. Hi, Natalie. How are you? Really nice to see you guys. If you've got questions or if you want to chat, go ahead and pop them in the Q&A box. I'm very excited to be here. I've got nothing on my face. So I came into town with my mask on, took my mask off and had a bright red nose, which is bizarre. Hi, Lucy. How are you doing? Happy Christmas. Hi, Ellen. Hi, Angela. Lovely to see you guys. Just going to see if I can move that up and down. Bear with me. Oh, there we go. Louise. Hi, Linda. Is that working? Rebecca. You suit being in the Clarins boutique? Why, thank you. So in a moment, I shall get started with some skincare. I do love myself a little bit of Clarins skincare. In fact, while... Before I get started, why don't I just do a little bit of, hi Gina, how are you? Hi Dana, special hello to Dana. She's a school mum. I saw her in the park earlier today. How are you doing? A masterclass with Hannah has become a permanent fixture for me over lockdown. Ah, well, I've done a fair few, that's for sure, but I'm delighted to be here today with Clarins. And I've got the most beautiful selection of makeup in front of me. I'm just using some of the micellar water just to refresh my skin. And we're going to create, or we're, please do your makeup along with me if you so wish, but I'm going to be creating a festive, sparkly, of course, slightly smoky eye look. But what I'll do is when we get there, when we get to eyes, Clarins have got the most beautiful, shall I tease you? This is the one I think I want to use. Isn't she beautiful? This is the Brown Sugar Gradation Eye Quad. But there are loads of stunning ones, like kind of slightly more pinkies, slightly more reddy burnish. There's a beautiful kind of forest green and khaki, that teal. Oh, right there is absolutely beautiful. And a kind of silver, granite and blue. Woo! So lots of things to get the creative juices flowing. Sarah, you've got bubbles. Well, I'm very impressed you have bubbles to watch. Quite right. What could be better on a Saturday evening? So I think we'll get started. Now we're a couple of minutes in. So I've done my micellar water just to cleanse my skin, take off my train journey, and I'm going to go into Clarins Double Serum. I'm sure there are lots of people watching who use Clarins Double Serum. Now you can choose whether you have, we've just been laughing about this here in the boutique, you can have a big pump or a little pump, but I always go for big. And you know what? I've realized I've gotten ahead of myself already. That's because I'm so excited. I need to tell you that you can book your own one-to-one with a Clarins expert here in the virtual boutique. So if you've got any specific questions, skincare needs, makeup questions, go ahead, go on the website and book yourself a one-to-one appointment here in the virtual boutique with a Clarins expert. Also, just for you lovely lot this evening, if you spend £35 this evening, you can put a code in at the checkout. That's Hannah I, and that will get you a free eyeshadow brush worth £20. If you spend over £70 and put into the checkout the code Hannah Face, you will get a foundation brush and an eyeshadow brush. This is worth £20. This is worth £26. So brush goodie treats just in time for Christmas. There we go. Glad I remembered that. Ooh. Okay, double serum. 21 different plant extracts go into making this. Ooh. Beautiful serum, just quite as magic as it is. Was that two pumps or one? But I feel I was quite restrained there. I'm just gonna press it into my skin. Oh my goodness. And it's just a joyful experience. It's obviously it's your skin food, but it's also the first step of hydrating your skin. Now at this time of year, I don't know about you, but my skin struggles a bit with the switch into central heating, then the mix up when you then go outside into the colder air. So you might find that your skin needs just a little bit more moisture than it does kind of during the warmer months. So I can't recommend the deliciousness that is the double serum. Then I'm going to layer up with the plant gold. And again, just like the double serum, it's kind of held in two separate vials in the actual packaging. How incredible is that? It's so that you mix the ingredients yourself so they are at their very freshest and most active. So I'm going to do two pumps of that. And you can see I've got a mixture of moisturizer and oil. And again, I like to warm it up in my hands first, and then I'm just going to press that into my face as well. Lisa, good morning in Vancouver. How lovely to have you joining us today. And Angela, I'm so pleased you've enjoyed this year's masterclasses. Oh my gosh, this feels so delightful. And what you should see is that my skin will have regained some maybe I had lost earlier through not having any kind of moisturizing product on. What's also great about the double serum and the plant gold is that they both work really well as kind of skin prep before makeup. So I'm a huge believer in that, you know, a fair amount of skincare is really essential if you want your makeup to look as natural and as skin-like as possible. If you dive straight into your makeup, that's when you can sometimes see makeup texture, or you know when just foundation feels a little bit like it's sitting on your skin and not necessarily melting in. That's what I'm trying to say. I'm also just trying to take the lid off. There we go. My multi-active eye. So this is the Clarins eye cream, but look, you squeeze it up gently, but then it's got this wonderful cryo applicator tip. So the tip's metal. Oh my goodness, I'm just gonna take a moment, sorry guys. And you can just blend and massage that into your under eye. And yes, of course the eye cream is doing its wondrous thing, but that cooling effect of the applicator, not only is it really relaxing, I could just keep doing this for hours. I shan't, because that'd be dull for you guys. It feels wonderful, but it also helps with that kind of immediate slight tightening feeling around the eye. And I, you know, I'm really quite self-conscious about my under eye area. I feel like it's quite, it can get quite dark and it can get quite puffy. And actually the physical act of massaging gently with that metal tip, just, yeah, it refreshes and I do believe it reduces my puffiness. So there we go. Now I do love a primer. Clarins have many. So the SOS primer, I've chosen the illuminating one, number 8, Rosy Gold Pearls, because I want my skin to glow this evening, but they do have ones that I carry in my kit. So different shades for different purposes, whether you need a bit of color correcting, whether you want some redness toned down, you know, we've got yellow, green, lilac, all wondrous primers. So I highly recommend you look into those. And if you've got any questions about the primers, then do please ask someone on the Clarins team. They will be able to help advise which primer is best suited to your skin. But let me show you this beautiful illuminating primer. So it does have some very soft, light reflective illuminating pearls. Oh, now what you could do if you wanted kind of subtle glow is you could just dot over the higher points of the face. So anywhere you'd want the light to linger, so kind of over the temples and the top of the cheeks, maybe a bit down the nose. You can use this if you're on the school run or just working from home, but want a little bit of life to your skin if you're doing any video calls or anything. I like to use it under makeup. You can mix it into your makeup. So mix into your foundation to give your foundation a bit of glow. But I'm actually just going to put it a bit everywhere because I absolutely love the very gentle, it's very subtle, but it's really beautiful, healthy glow that you see coming through. You apply this. So you can kind of spot highlight certain areas, but I'm just going and applying it all over because I'm absolutely in love with the effect that you get when you have that gentle lit from within luminosity coming through your makeup. It's a brilliant cheat. You know, if you've overindulged at home with any kind of festive plans, you can pop this on and you don't look like you're potentially feeling a bit groggy. Okay, how's the skin looking? Are we glowing, guys and girls? Because I think I will move into foundation. Now I'm going to use the Everlasting Youth Fluid. I've been using this, I want to say, for about a year or just over a year, and I absolutely love it. I love that it's a really good coverage, but it doesn't look or it doesn't feel heavy. So I was wearing this maybe 2-3 days ago, and I had so many people ask me what foundation it was. So if you're looking for a breathable foundation that's, I'd say, medium coverage that also has skincare benefit, then this is the one for you. I'm using the shade Honey. Now I do flit, but Honey is a good color match at the moment. So I've dotted over my face and I'm just gonna blend using the foundation brush. And I do love this kind of flat paddled foundation brush. It just does a really good job of blending. I'll just blend the foundation in bit by bit. You can use as much or as little as you like. So it might be that you want something really light looking, in which case you can mix some of this Everlasting Youth Fluid, even with your double serum, for a really very sheer, really light application. Or you can mix it with your SOS primer if you want for kind of a little bit more coverage, but still not full. And then I've done what I'd say is kind of medium coverage. And you could use more if you wanted to build it to full coverage. And actually, I was delighted when I was watching Sally Hughes talk about her love for this foundation. I was kind of fist pumping the air as she was talking about it, because everything she said about it's, you know, brilliant property, full agreement with. So there we go. If you feel you need a bit more to cover any redness, then go ahead. Generally, as a rule of thumb with foundation, I do suggest you start kind of through the center of the face, so anywhere where you might carry a bit of redness, just because red can be a really distracting color. So if there's red around the nose or around the chin, just focus your foundation there first and then blend out. You just want to make sure that you neutralize your base as much as possible. So now we'll move into a little bit of concealer. I'm going to use the Instant Concealer, shade number 2. Now this is actually, it's 15 mils. I just want to point out that that's a big old lot of concealer you've got in there. And you don't need much. So I put a bit on the back of my hand there. A little bit goes a really long way. So I'm starting with shade number 2. I'm just going to dot a little bit of that just into the inner corner of my eyes, just to brighten up and try and disguise any kind of dark colour. When you're doing this yourself, always be mindful just to tap there at the very inner corner of the eye and kind of on the side of the bridge of the nose, because a lot of us have a couple of veins and capillaries in that area, and if you don't conceal them, they can give a dark shadow to the inner corner of the eye. And especially when you're doing a darker eye, you want to make sure that the under eye area is as light as possible. Now, I'm actually going to take a little bit of that and pop it on the tip of my red nose. I think that must have been my mask, you know. And then what we'll do is we'll go ahead and do the rest of my makeup, but we can always go back to the under eye area and brighten further once it's done. So I'll often do that with my clients, actually. I'll do the base, I'll then start to work on the eye, and if necessary, I'll go back to the under eye area and kind of brighten further if I think that's necessary. So there we go, just a little bit of extra colour on the tip of my nose. Now, before I do any powder, I want to finish using all of my cream based products. And in front of me, I've got the Glow To Go Duo Blush and Highlighter. There's also I've got the Golden Peach. So it's a beautiful creamy peach blush. And on the other end, you've got this beautiful creamy bronzing end, which I'm going to use to warm my skin tone. There's also a beautiful, which is stunning, with a gorgeous pink blush and an iridescent kind of pinky highlight. They're so beautiful and so handy when you are on the go. So let me do a little bit of the bronze one, shall I? So I like to add my warmth. I'm not contouring as such. I don't want it over the top of my cheeks. So just do straight from the bullet there. And then I'm going to put it over the top of my forehead as well. So it might look a bit bizarre at the moment, but trust me, it all blends beautifully. So I'm just going to dab actually with my two middle fingers. So using the very flat of the pad of my finger. And I just find that just buffs and melts this beautiful highlighting bronzer into the skin for the most natural looking finish. You can use your foundation brush as well if you want to. And I've kept it relatively high. So this is definitely much more of a bronzer look than it is a contouring look. But that's just my preference. If you want to do something slightly more contoured, then you just take it lower and take it, you know, underneath the cheekbone. But I'm going over the cheekbone and on top. There we go. So what we achieve is a really lovely natural looking bronze. Let me do the same over the top of my forehead. And then the good thing is, with any excess that you've got on your fingers, you can then take a bit on the nose if you want to warm up. You might find you want to take a little bit on your neck if your neck is significantly lighter than your chest. I know that can be the case for a lot of us. Don't know where my eyes were looking there. Sorry. I'm just blending that in. It's funny, I know a lot of you laugh that I say forehead. I don't know why, but I've just always grown up calling it my forehead. But I know a lot of people think that's very bizarre. Are you team forehead or team forehead? There we go. That's better. So my skin is looking warm and bright. And actually, I know I said I wasn't contouring, but the simple act of adding warmth to the top of your cheeks and your forehead does help create or kind of emphasize a bit of shape to the face by creating shade. So I find that really is really flattering, actually, just to put a bit of color in where foundation has done a brilliant job of evening things out. Now, going back to eyes, I think I'm going to stick with my plan and go with the brown sugar gradation, in which case I want to do, I think, more of a pinky looking blush. So I won't use the peach in this just now. Let me go into the beautiful cheeky rose blush. Now, I do love, look, that the lid of the blush alludes to the shade of the blush inside. As a makeup artist, that's so handy when I'm rootling in my kit, because I don't have to open each one to know which shade I'm going for. But let me show you a couple of my other favourites. This is the Cheeky Boom. number five, and it's a soft pinky peach, but there are flecks of gold, which is really pretty if you want to create a bit more of a kind of highlight. If you like a really soft baby pink, then this is Cheeky Baby. Isn't she gorgeous? And then we've got some really pretty peachy tones as well. Cheeky Coral and Cheeky Peach, again, with the colour coordinating lids. Love, love, love. But I'm going to use the Cheeky Rose, just using the blush brush. It's going to swirl over the pigment. And then as always, I always advise, when you're trying to work out where to place your blush, just smile at yourself right in front of the mirror and then start dusting over the apple of the cheek and that blushed, and then just will melt back into the bronzer that you've applied. And again, it's just the next step in helping you look as fresh and as healthy as possible. So if you are working a lot from home on the computer at the moment, dip into your blush before those meetings just to help you look and feel that little bit brighter. So I'm a fan of a lot of blush. I don't know if that's too much. So let me just go back into my foundation brush and just blend the edges. Again, this is something I do on my clients all the time, and it's purely an exercise in trying to make the blush look as natural as possible. You don't want to see any edges where your blush starts or where your blush finishes. So don't worry about using a different brush. Go ahead and just blend. There we go. So what you should get is a much more seamless, diffused blush that looks like you, but just at your very, very healthiest. I'm just going to see if I can scroll down and see if there are any questions. Hi, guys. Hannah, that's someone answering a question, isn't it? Hi, Louise. How are you doing? Hi, Ellen. Okay. So I also want to show you a really fun trick. And this is another one of the blushes. This is Cheeky Mocha. And I'm going to use that to set my bronzer. So I've done a creamy base bronzer, which is great, just to ensure it lasts. I'm just going to go in with the big powder brush into the Cheeky Mocha. And I'm just going to use this kind of slightly warmer blush as a setting powder for my bronzer. It's just another way of making kind of, you know, festive, luminous looking makeup actually really long wearing and kind of bulletproof. And that's something that I've worked a lot on in my career, creating really wearable, fresh, healthy looking makeup looks that will last and last. There's nothing more annoying than doing your makeup and either it's sliding off or just, you know, it not wearing quite as you'd like. So that's my bronzer set. I'm now going to dip into the loose powder. Again, I'm going to use the big brush. I'm going to work at setting my T-zone. So I want definitely plenty of glow to my skin. I'm sure that all the skincare I've used and the SOS primer will ensure that I maintain that glow, but I want to make sure it lasts. So think of standing over your roast potatoes on the 25th. You don't want all of that steam to move your makeup. So setting with a bit of powder will just keep it in place for the day. Now you'll notice I'm not going to the outer corners of my face because I've pretty much set that with the Cheeky Mocha. So I'm really just focusing on the center. There we go, brilliant. All the while maintaining the glow from my glow to go on the apples, no, cheekbones. That's the word I was looking for. Okie doke. So before I do eyes, I always like to frame my brows. I think it really helps just create a brilliant framework to work with. So I'm going to go into my brow duo, and this is the shade medium brown. Now, I cannot tell you how marvelous this is. So you've got this fine tipped applicator that's coated in soft powder pigments. When you apply it, it feels a little bit wet. Yeah, it's pretty special. So let me just start by showing you how I use it. So I like to just fluff first through the head of my brow. just to fill in, because then on the end there is a spoolie with a brow mascara also. But look how soft, I mean, it's good colour, isn't it? It's nice and defining, but you'd get none of the harshness that you get with some pencils. It just seems like a much more subtle way of applying. And the difference, my goodness, hello brow, what's this? Hey, so let me just work on my other brow. And for me, I don't know about you, but the head of my brow is the area that needs the most attention. So that's usually where I start first. So just lots of light little strokes through the brows, just making sure that that powder pigment just settles right behind the hairs. And I'm just following the direction of the growth of the hairs. There we go. And just fill in the top of this brow is a little bit sparse. I'm just gently filling through there and then just strengthening the tail of the brow slightly. I don't want that mirror to confuse you guys, sorry. There we go. And then let me show you the other end, because it's really cool. It's a really delicate brow brush. It's really, look how mini that is, which is so good for precision. I'm just going to remove any excess on my hand a sec. And then you can just brush that through the hairs and it adds a bit more colour, but it will just hold your brows in place for the rest of the day, which is so handy. I don't know about you, but because my brows are quite long, they can get a bit unruly. And sometimes if they fall, it can make them look a little bit heavy. So it's great to have this brilliant kind of setting coloured gel at the other end to keep the brows in place. You know, it just means you can get your brows on and you just don't have to think about them again for the rest of the day. There we go. So are we ready to get into a little bit of eye? I certainly am. So let me start. I'm actually going to start with pencil. Now, I quite regularly start my eye makeup with eye pencil. Just at the lash line, it just gives you an idea of, you know, a little bit of depth, and you can work on how much you build that eye look depending on, you know, what takes your fancy. So let me start just doing a little bit of definition with that pencil now. I do love that it's a twist up pencil as well, so there's none of that stress of having to dash for a sharpener. I'm just going to start using some of this pencil just at the very outer corner of the eye. So just pulling out from the outer corner. I'm probably going just short of half the way across the eye. And then I can leave it at that, but I'm just going to blend it just by dabbing with my finger gently. And I'm just starting a tiny bit of the defining process. So let me do the same on the other side. Just taking that waterproof pencil very gently in the outer corner, just shy of halfway across the lid, and then you can just blend gently with your finger. So it just helps me see, yeah, what that lash line looks like when it has something a little bit darker next to it. If you want to, I can show you now, can't I? I can show you now. I was going to say, these liners are great if you want to use them almost a bit like an eyeshadow base. So I'm just taking that all the way along the lash line and then just pulling it up a little over my lid. And then I can press the eyeshadows into it for a slightly more intense look. And I figure, as it's, you know, it's nearly Christmas, I might as well do something a little bit smoky. So just pop that on your lower lid. I always like to blend with my ring finger. And I tell you what, if you're in a rush, actually sometimes just that bit of smudged liner and mascara is enough to make you feel really quite polished and, you know, pulled together. So pencils can be brilliant for both lining and creating the illusion of shadow at the same time. So let me do the same on the other side. So just doing lots of little strokes, almost blending the strokes together bit by bit as I apply them. And then I'm going to go in with my ring finger and just smooth that. But you know, this could be the world's quickest and easiest gentle smoky eye, couldn't it? But I'm using this more as a base, kind of from which to build my eyeshadow look. So let me grab, I'm holding it. Let me grab the eyeshadow quad. Hannah, it's right in your hand. So I'm going to start by using this really pretty, soft, kind of pale bronzy colour. And I'm going to work that all the way over my lower lid. I'm just going to start pressing into the, look at that, isn't that colour stunning? I'm going to take it all the way over. I'm not going to take it right into the inner corner of my eye because I'm going to save that for the pale gold. I do love to kind of highlight the inner corner of the eye, especially at this time of year. It just gives an eye a slightly more festive feel, doesn't it? And I'm going to bring that just up into the crease of the eye. Pretty, a nice place to start, hey? The great thing about this quad is you've got four colours with which you can build your eyeshadow look. But it's nice to create your kind of staple main movable part of the lid colour and then build around that. And what I love, and what I think what drew me to this palette in particular, A, I do love this as an everyday kind of lid colour. I absolutely love the gold for something a bit more kind of party-like, but you know, you guys know, I absolutely adore these kind of muted matte taupey tones. I think they are just the most genius bridging colours. So I'm going to go into that lovely matte taupey tone. I'm tapping any excess into the palm of my hand, and that helps just ensure that you work the colour into the bristles of your brush so they're not left sitting on the surface. And it just means when you then come to blend them over the eye, you'll get a much softer, more diffused blend of colour rather than too much intense pigment. Whereas with the eyeshadow brush, when I was doing the more kind of slightly bronzy colour, I did use a bit more of a pressing action because I want my lid colour to be intense. So pat and press when you want the colour to be intense, work the product into the brush and sweep when you want it to be slightly softer. So that's what I'm doing here with this taupey tone. So I'm just sweeping through the crease of the eye, pulling it really quite high, not fully up to the eyebrow, but nice and high so that when your eyes are open, you can see that colour. Now, if your eyes are hooded at all, mine are slightly hooded, just be careful that you don't bring that colour too low. If you bring the colour too low, you can exacerbate the appearance of a slightly hooded eye. If your eye is very hooded, my advice to you is you definitely want to keep that shadow up high through the crease of the eye so when your eyes are open you can see the colour, but practice pulling your colour straight out. Might feel a bit weird initially, but try pulling that colour straight out. It'll give you a bit more of a lifted look, and just be sure that you don't take your shadow past that corner of your eye. So use a brush, take it from the corner of your nose to the corner of your eye to the edge of your eyebrow, and your shadow shouldn't come any lower than that. Okay, you can always go in after with a finger and just swipe up. It will just create a slightly more lifted look. And I mention that because I'm asked about hooded eyes all the time. Right, let me do the same on the other side. So I've patted that beautiful matte taupey colour into my brush, and then I'm just going to sweep back and forth through the crease of my eye, blending that gorgeous, slightly shimmering bronze with the skin just above as a really beautiful bridging colour before I hit my brow bone. Now, I don't know about you, but I do like bringing it all a little bit higher if I'm looking to create something, you know, a little bit more glam. Nice. Then I'm going to go, I think, along my lower lash line. Let's get the eyeshadow brush again. I'm going to go first with the pretty soft bronze colour. And let's just sweep that along the lower lash line. What I do like to suggest when doing a bit of shadow liner along your lower lash line is I always suggest keeping it a bit thicker than you think you should. So if your liner along the lower lash line is quite thin, that's when it can look a little bit hard. So the thicker and deeper you bring, or kind of lower you bring that colour down, the smokier and kind of smudgier that look is. And actually it's that little bit softer looking as well. But I do think when you're trying to create a bit more of a festive, smoky eye, that it's really nice to do liner top and bottom for a bit more of a made up finish. If you're worried about your eyes looking small, or if you're worried about your eyes looking particularly tired, then you might want to omit this. But I do think for kind of a Saturday evening, bit of a smoky eye, you can't go wrong with a little bit of liner all the way around the edge. Now, if you want to make it a bit deeper, you can go into the darkest colour. I'm just going to get a bit of that darkest colour in the quad onto my eyeshadow brush. I'm just going to put that right in the outer corner, just to make that outer corner of my eye just a little bit deeper. Let me do the same on the other side. There we go. It just helps to, sorry, I put the palette in front of the camera then. It just helps to frame the eye that little bit better. Now it's time to dip into the gold. I'm going to do that with the eyeshadow brush. So I'm just cleaning off the tip of the shadow brush. I'm going to go into this beautiful light reflective gold, and watch this. I'm just going to press it into that inner corner of my eye. Isn't that pretty? I absolutely love it. So I'm pressing it into the inner corner, and then you can just pull it out and start kind of bringing it across the lid slightly. But it really does help, doesn't it? Just brighten the entire look. It's, you know, it's not necessary for the look. You don't have to do it. But I absolutely love the finish. Another fun thing you could do, if you wanted to, instead of highlighting the inner corner of the eye, you could use the gold to highlight the very center. Now, that's called a bit more of a halo eye because it creates that halo of light effect. But that's another really beautiful option for a pretty festive look. I'm just making sure I blend that from the inner corner slightly into that lid first, more bronzy lid colour. Nice. Particularly good in candlelight, I would say, this kind of brightening of the inner corner of the eye look. It's also really helpful if you fear that your eyes, if they're maybe set quite close together, if you highlight the inner corner, it will just help give illusion of a bit more space and light. So if that's you, I would recommend highlighting the inner corner of your eyes. Okay, now let's go back to, I'm going to go back to a little bit of the eyeliner pencil, just so I can strengthen the root of the lashes a bit. And that will just mean that when I come to do my mascara in a second, that my lash line will look that little bit more dense and a little bit more impactful. And you can see that I'm just doing lots and lots of little strokes with the eyeliner pencil. I know some people don't wear eyeliner because they're worried that they can't do it all at once, but I just want to encourage you that you don't have to do one perfect line in one perfect stroke. You can just use this brilliantly soft waterproof pencil to do lots and lots of little strokes. You kind of blend together as you work to create your line. It doesn't have to be one perfect line all at once. Okay. Nice. So the pièce de résistance really with this eye look is finishing with some of the mascara Supra Volume. Oh my goodness. Let me show you. It is such a thick, rich formula that it doesn't take much for this eye to be framed brilliantly. Let me just do, there we go, just a couple of seconds worth of strokes. It's good, isn't it? But I would suggest, if you're trying to do something a bit more festive, just spend a bit of time with your mascara just to get full framing and full impact. And I always like to say, when you're looking at doing your mascara, when you're working through the center, pull straight up. So pull your lashes straight up, and that will create volume right at the highest point of your lashes. When you come to the inner corner, pull in towards your nose, and that will create a fanned effect from the central lashes into the inner corner of the eye, and then your outer corner lashes, that's where you can pull them out towards the tip, or the end, should I say, of your eyebrow. I haven't so much this year, but usually on my daily commute, I watch people on the tube quickly, frantically brushing their mascara, quite often, you know, to one side. And whilst that's sweet and you do get a nice bit of fan effect in the outer corner, you do then lose some of that height that you can achieve when you pull straight up. And the joy of this formula is that it does so much of the work for you. And be sure when you're doing it that you twist your brush. So I'm working at one point of the brush here. I'm now going to turn it, and there I can get maximum mascara out of that bit of the brush. Then I can turn it again. And I'm just suggesting you do that so you really do maximize the product, because there's a lot of product on that wand. You don't necessarily need to keep dipping it in and out of the tube. Just once, if you've used up all the mascara on the angle that you're using, just twist it and use up the mascara on the opposite side. Again, just pulling those inner corner lashes in towards my nose, because I want to create a full fan effect. And then, because I've done a slightly smoky look, let's do a little bit of mascara on the lower lashes, shall we? So I don't know about you, but when I come to do my lower lashes, I like to tease with the very tip of my mascara wand. So I turn it vertically and I almost tickle the lower lashes. For me, it just seems to be that when doing it on myself, but also when I'm working with clients, it seems to eliminate the risk of getting too much mascara on the skin behind the lashes. So if you're one of those people who doesn't do their lower lashes because you worry about getting mascara on the skin, try twisting, just turning your wand vertically, and just try tickling with the tip of your mascara. Let me do the same on the other side. If you're blessed with really long lower lashes, and maybe because of that you don't wear mascara on your lower lashes because you're worried it's going to make your lashes look too long, what you can do, and I'll show you here, is you can literally just pinch the bottom of your lash, and that will just take off the tip or the excess mascara on the very tip of the lashes, making the lashes look a bit shorter. I, however, absolutely love a lashy look, so I don't mind my lower lashes looking a little bit longer. And I think I picked this up from my mother. You know, she used to spend ages on her mascara, and then, and I do not advise you try this at home, once she'd got all her mascara on, she then got one of my nappy pins, of which I've kept all of them, and she'd fastidiously separate each lash bit by bit, but her lashes looked incredible. Don't try that at home. Your mascara wand will do that for you. Okay, great. Now, I discovered this lip product this week. Well, no, yes, I'll start there. I discovered this lipstick this week and I'm ever so slightly obsessed. In fact, you know, I'm one of those people that I hoard things that I love. So I wouldn't be surprised if I did a huge bulk order. It's the Jolie Rouge in Sandy Pink. And let me just show you, I haven't got any lip balm on. Before I came live, I put a bit of my eye cream on my lips. Yes, great tip. Think of all that wonderful eye cream goodness working on the skin around the edge of your lips. So excellent, but it's also really wonderfully moisturizing and nourishing. But this lipstick formula, let me just put some on for you. It's so hydrating and creamy. What do we think? Isn't that the most beautiful colour? It's not often, I say once in a blue moon, I find a lipstick that makes me this excited. This lipstick has made me so excited. I shared it on my Instagram this week. I will keep sharing it. Isn't it lovely? It's number 758. For those of you with a pen and paper, 758 Jolly Rouge Sandy Pink. Can't recommend it highly enough. Now, I'd say there are two things I want to do before I finish this look. I want to do a little bit of my lip perfector. These are so my favourite thing in the world. If you haven't tried them, where have you been? Let me help you fall in love with them. They are tinted, moisturising lip balms with a glossy finish that feel gorgeous. They're not overly sticky. They smell divine. They are just, well, they do what they say they do. They do perfect the appearance of your lips. Now, I can't remember which one I've got in my coat today, but I have these in every handbag, every coat pocket. They just help me feel put together. I always feel comfortable when the skin on my lips is hydrated. I feel really self-conscious when they're dry. I was putting one of these on pre-COVID, and my friend Ruth was like, oh my goodness, I love that. I was like, then you need to have it. And I just gave it to her there and then. I can't preach my love for these enough. This is the shade number 6. I've got 7 in front of me as well. This is the toffee shimmer, isn't it? But let me do number 6. So just squeeze up. Oh, I'm christening a new one. This is a very happy moment. So just squeeze a bit up and then just go straight onto the lip. And again, brilliant for the school run because I don't even need to look at what I'm doing. I can just squeeze and apply and go. And it just gives the most beautiful sheen. They feel so comfortable. They are beautiful over lipstick. They're beautiful worn on their own. Yeah, something I think everyone who likes lip product should own. They come in a number of different colours. They come in different formulas. In fact, there's a Lip Perfector Velvet, which is a kind of matte version. Stop. But they're totally wonderful. Number 8 is brilliant if you're looking for something a bit more berry-ish. So, brilliant product to have to kind of finish off your makeup. It's great. I love it on the school run when I'm not wearing anything else. Maybe just a bit of my illuminating SOS primer and a bit of that. And then I want to do a bit of glitter on my eyes because to me, a little bit of sparkle just completes a festive, smoky eye look. So I've got 3 in front of me. They're called the Ombre Sparkle. This is called Gold Diamond. Just love it. Then we have got Blue Lagoon. So pretty. Imagine Blue Lagoon over this eye quad. Amazing. And then we also have the Peach Girl. But because I've done kind of a bronzy, kind of goldy look, let me do a little bit of the Gold Diamond. So I think they're best applied with your finger. So just take a bit on your ring finger. They are so highly pigmented, guys. I'm just going to press that over my shadow, and it just gives the most beautiful shimmering sparkle. It's a slightly metallic finish. I feel like I should do the blue on the other eye to show you, but I'm actually enjoying my makeup too much, so I want to keep it the same. So let me just press a bit of that onto my lid. So they couldn't be easier, guys. Just press with your ring finger very gently and you'll get that beautiful metallic shimmer, which can be the perfect way to jazz up your day makeup. So if you've done your eye look and you've been wearing it all day, but you want to do something a bit more exciting for the evening, you can just take a bit of these beautiful ombre sparkle shadows and just, yeah, liven up your eye look. So I'm looking at all the gorgeous products in front of me. I think I should probably stop there, but here we go. This is my festive bronzy gold smoky eye using all Clarins products. Now let me come back here and see if I can access any questions. If you've got any questions, now is the time to ping those to me. She says, let me work out this one. Oh, if I'm struggling, just don't mind me. I'm just absolutely rubbish at technology. Would you do anything different for hooded eyes? Michelle, I hope I answered that question a moment ago. For those of us with fringes, how important do you think brows are? Do you need to bother with them? Oh, Louise, yes. Yes, because all it takes is a slight gust of wind and your hair can be moved from your forehead and you may see your brows. So I do think it depends how heavy your fringe is. If it's a very long, heavy fringe and you're pretty sure you're not going to see your brows, then yeah, sure, don't worry. But I think it's still really lovely, even if you do have a bit of a fringe, to have your brows filled in and framed so that you still get that definition around the eye. So yeah, I absolutely would. Let me see if I can bring this up a bit. Oh, look, I can track it with my fingers. Oh, happy Christmas to you too, Lucy. Hi, hi, hi. Would you set your makeup with a setting spray? Funny you ask that, Lauren, because look what I've got. I've got the Fix makeup spray. So yeah, they're fab, especially if you've done your makeup and you know you're going to be wearing a mask. Oh my gosh, it's rose. It's got rose water in it as well. It smells absolutely divine. So yes, I do highly recommend setting sprays. Which Lip Perfector is the more nude one? I'd say that's the number 6 that I've just used. 1 and 2 are more kind of creamy pinky. Oi. I'm pulling the track down, but it's always going back to the same question. Why do you choose a pink blush, not a coral, with a brown eyeshadow? Amanda, great question. Usually I pick pink over peach because sometimes peach on the skin can read a little bit flat or a bit brown. So I do love peaches and I wear them a lot and I do apply peach to clients of mine. But if I'm looking for, if I'm trying to create a look that brings the most vibrancy and life to the skin, then a soft pink, I think, does that more effectively. So it mirrors you when your skin's a bit flushed better than a peach will. I hope that's answered that question. Ellen, I'm pleased you've learned skin prep from me. You can never scrimp on skincare. It's like baking, isn't it? If you've got a horrible batch of cake mix. No, what do I mean? Cake's not dough, is it? Anyway, if you make a cake and you miss out a couple of ingredients and bake it anyway, and then slap on a load of delicious icing, it's still not going to be a great cake. I don't think I nailed that analogy, but I hope you got the gist. You've got to put your work in on your skincare and your skin prep so your skin is at its healthiest, yes, long term, but also immediately that your skin is ready to hold makeup. There we go. We got there in the end. I'm sat at your desk. Shannon, thank you for letting me sit at your desk. I'm having a great time. I might never want to go home, you know. What would the lipstick you use suit an Asian skin tone, Christina? Yeah, what you might want to do, it depends on the tone of your actual lip colour. You might want to use a slightly darker lip pencil. If you want just to line the lips slightly, that could help if you fear it's a bit light. Does Clarins have perfume? I'll have to get the Clarins team to answer that one. I've just tried your eye cream on the lip tricks and my lips feel amazing. Lucy, I am absolutely thrilled. Can you do a breakdown of the skincare products, please? You missed the start. Oh, Rebecca, I'm so sorry. What a shame. Very quickly then, just to recap, we use the micellar water just to kind of cleanse and clean. The double serum to feed and start hydrating. The plant gold as a really brilliant moisturizer. Then we did the multi-active eye on eyes and lips and the SOS primer number 8, Rosy Gold Pearls. I hope that helps. Is there a good trick for stopping liner moving on hooded eyes? You find it transfers. Yeah. So if that's you, oh gosh, I lost the question. Kathleen, then take a bit of your pressed, your loose powder and really work it into the skin through the crease of your eye. So you are mattifying and absorbing any oil that you might have on the lid. That will stop the liner you've used from melting into that skin. So just mattify with powder the crease of your eye, and that will stop your liner from moving. This is also a waterproof eyeliner pencil, so they really don't budge. How do you stop your base from separating on skin and going patchy? Francesca, I find that when foundation does go patchy on the skin, it's often because your skin is dehydrated when you applied it. So I don't know for sure if that's the case with you, Francesca, but I would suggest, I would look at ensuring your skin is really adequately hydrated before you apply your makeup. And can I just say that you need all of these amazing skincare products, but you also need to drink lots of water. Drinking water is miraculous for helping your skin look its absolute best. When placing blush, how can you lift the apple of your cheeks? How can you lift your apples of your cheeks? Bring it higher. So I used to work with someone who said your blusher should kiss your under eye. So just bring it slightly higher. Yeah, if you place your blush too low, that's when it can bring the face down a bit. So right high on the very top of the apple of the cheek. Tiffany, I'm going on a sunny holiday next week, you lucky thing. What one face product would you take? Lots of sunshine and high humidity. SPF. And then because you're going to be outside, I presume, and having a lovely time, I just use an illuminating primer to get that gorgeous glow. Yes. Lauren. Oh, question's gone. Have you used the smoothing perfecting primer? Yes, I don't have my pot here. Yes, I have. And yes, it's amazing. So I like to use it just around the corners of my lips, just here under my eye. Anywhere you want to kind of blur and smooth, it's great. Would blue shades work on hazel green eyes? Vicky, absolutely. Although I'd love to see blue with hazel green. Yeah, those with hazel eyes are so lucky. You can get away with any kind of colour spectrum. I think anyone of any eye colour can, of course, play with whatever colours you're drawn to. But blue on hazel eyes is incredible. And actually, what can be really nice is if you don't want to go full blue, you could just say, pick out one of the brighter blues in the palette and just do your under eye liner with that. That could be fun for a Christmas look. This is my first time with you, Hannah, but I've learned so much. I'm 64 and love Clarins. Ah, wonderful, Karen. What's the very best tip for dry looking eyelids? So I would say, Karen, the best thing to do is use your multi-active eye at night on your brow bone. So ensure that all that wonderful goodness of the eye cream can seep down onto your eyelids. I wonder if the Clarins team can recommend a specific, maybe there's a slightly richer cream that could be better for you. And then I'd say stick to matte shadows might exacerbate the appearance of dryness. So actually that's when a shimmer can be really flattering. So just a light shimmer that you can press in. I'm very jealous of Tiffany going on a sunny holiday. I'd love to. Hannah, any tips for fine lines around the lips? Yes, Louisa Llewellyn. Use your eye cream around your lips. It's wonderful. All that wonderful active goodness working wonders around the lip. You've tried the serum before and it's amazing. I'm so pleased. Bridget, the sparkle I used was the gold diamond sparkle. I love it. What colours for brown eyes? Bridal. Oh, Celia, you could use any number of them, but I would love to see these beautiful rosewood gradation colours on a brown eyes for bridal. So pretty, kind of soft, muted plums and pinks. Mm! Absolutely delicious. I'm just scrolling down here for questions. Have I answered them all? Because I'm just not convinced. How can we make them last all day? Your powder and your setting spray is going to do loads. Claire, I'm delighted you've learnt lots. It's been my absolute pleasure to sit here and chat to you all. I'm sorry I can't see you all, but I have the best fun doing these masterclasses. And finally, what's the code again? Yeah, so if you spend £35, you want to use the code HANNAHI, all in capitals, and that will get you an eyeshadow brush. And if you spend £70, you want to use the code HANNAHFACE, and you'll get a foundation brush and an eyeshadow brush. What a treat, just in time for Christmas. All right, guys, thank you so, so, so much for joining me. I hope we can do this again. I've had a great time. If you don't already, feel free to follow me on Instagram. It's Hannah Martin Makeup, and I'd be happy to answer any further questions you might have. So it just leaves me to say, have a lovely evening and have a healthy, safe, and happy Christmas. Lots of love, guys.